Hello, once again, rock and rollers, jazzers, funksters. Hope you're all doing good today. Welcome to another episode of Fulton Street Beats, where we lay down the groove and try to make you laugh a little bit at the same time. Hope everybody's doing all right. Well, it's off to a slow start with the channel switchover, but that's okay because we're enjoying ourselves and that's what we want to do here. We want to enjoy ourselves. So, if you're not familiar, sometimes what we do here other than reviews, and we will be doing a lot of reviews, trust me, got a lot in the works. Sometimes what we do here on Fulton Street Beats is we lay down, have a little thing where we listen to a track once that we've never heard before, and then we head over to the Roland VAD306 and we try to lay down that track. Now, we'll do something a little different today. I was talking to a buddy of mine on the phone. He says, "Mike, when's the last time you played any Rush?" And I said, "Well, I horse around with Neil Peart once in a while, but I really don't know a lot of the stuff. At least I don't think I do." So he says, "I really love YYZ. Could you play that for me?" I said, "Well, good, but it won't be that good." So I was scrolling through here and I listened to it. They got a couple of them here. And I was looking for a drumless track. It's a lot easier to play to the actual original album because their timing is right on. And if you guys do this, I don't know, this Guitar Hero stuff or whatever it is, band, whatever it is there, I don't know. I'm not a video gamer. They do this stuff and I listen to it through and timing's not right. Little off. I don't know why. I don't know if they do that for copyright reasons or whatnot, but it's a little off and it throws me off. But anyhow, I said, what the hell? I'll give it a try. So I listened through YYZ, the drumless one. That's for, I believe it's Rockband. And the timing is a little different. At least I think it is. Maybe it's been a while since I've heard it. So anyhow, even though I have heard this song before, many, many times, as a matter of fact, I used to listen to Rush back in the day all the time. Neil Peart was he was a god to everybody, right? Not really a god, but, you know, he was somebody that we looked to aspire to drum like him, at least. And, you know, of course, he's passed now, and then I look back at some of his stuff now and go, wow, you know, while recognized as a phenomenal drummer, which he really, really was, he really, really inspired a lot of people to start playing drums. And of course, nowadays we got new inspirations. I'm one of my favorite drummers is in the world is Ray Lazier. This guy, drummer for Korn. And what a well-trained musician he is that can cover pretty much any genre of music. And I think he was born, if I'm not mistaken, I've heard that he was born with drumsticks in his ass. He's that good, and he's phenomenal to watch, and he really enjoys what he's doing, and that's what it's about, and that's what we want to do on this channel, too. We want you to enjoy what you're doing. We don't care about skill levels. We care nothing about that. We're not here to critique. We're not here to put down. We are here to let you have fun and maybe laugh at me a little bit. And speaking of laughing, what's nice is when you play something and you mess up, and don't hide it. I do plenty of that here, especially when we do this game up here at once and play it once, as you guys have probably heard already. But today we're going to do something different. Let's give this Rush. I have listened to this just briefly, and so I'm listening twice, but I've heard this song throughout my life. But so I think I got an idea pretty much how it goes, and maybe it'll come back to me. But let's give it a listen through. This is Rush YYZ, purely instrumental. This is, I believe, rock band version, but it's drumless, and I don't want any drums playing behind me. I want my mistakes to be heard. So let's give it a listen. in C.
Cleopatra
after the commercials here, of course, we always get commercials. And let's give it a listen and see. It's not really a difficult intro. It's a lot of good timing, though. Switch up there. Cymbal catches, I believe. Something a little off time. I think I know it somewhat. It's going to be sloppy, guys. Yeah, this part right here on the ride cymbal, I think there's a ride going on. This is the hi-hat part. Remember that. Could be wrong. And we got the famous guns. I think there's a roll. Yep, I can hear it in the background a little bit. Seems like the timing is just a little step above or step back on this. I don't know. Now that din-din, I am not sure. I can hear it in the background a little bit. Okay, I'm not sure. A little ride. I'm not sure if on that part where it's the, just the bass, if he taps the cymbals in between or not. I want to say he does, but I could be wrong. Should be a fast roll right here. Right. Crashes. I don't know. I'm guessing. A rap app. I'm wrong in parts there, I know. That's going to be... That part's going to be tricky for me. I like that. I think that's right. Then we go back over to the right again. Right here, roll around. So, another hi-hat. I like that part. Sometimes that's... I remember playing that years ago. It's difficult to pull off. I don't think I've ever made it through this song, honestly. I don't think I've... Got a lot of kit to work with there. Rap-pap-pap-pap. Oh, the timing's weird on the end there, too. Yeah, that's weird. That's going to be a difficult one. There's a lot of changes in that. Wow. Okay, so that's my second time kind of listening through it. I'm trying to get a feel for it. I think I can kind of pull it off. He's fast with that single bass pedal, though. At least I think that's what he used. I don't think Neil Peart was a double bass man. I mean, maybe he was later on when he got into some of the later stuff, but I don't think on this album, I'm pretty sure that was a single bass pedal, just a rat. He's fast with that bass pedal, and I'm coming off a broken ankle, so I might throw in some double bass to get his speed notes in the beginning. Dun 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 dun. I might go ba ba dun 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 bum ba bum. I might throw in some double bass. We'll see how it works. I don't know. We'll play it by ear. So without any further ado, let's jump over onto the kit and play Mess Up That Neil Peart Song. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to mess it up pretty good. But hey, don't hold it against me. I'm trying, boys and girls. I suggest you guys challenge yourselves and do the same thing. I will be right back. Boy, Mama, I don't know. That was difficult. I don't like the way the recording is coming out in my headphones over there, for one. Can't hear anything properly. It's hard for me to pick up on the changes. I hope it comes out okay for the video, at least usable. It's hard for me to pick up on changes, and I'm trying to listen that step ahead so I could beat it. And I was dragging. Something about the timing in my mind that was just a little bit not right. So I may go back after this and play along to the original and see if I'm right on that. Check my tempo. Maybe set up the metronome and check my tempo. Make sure it's right. But it seemed a little bit off, but it's fun to play. I don't know if I'm doing half of it right. There were some parts that I simply screwed up, messed up. But I'm going by guessing, goddamn, because I really don't know what he's doing. I'm just guessing what he's doing and trying to make it sound like what it should in my head. You know what I mean? How I remember it. So probably totally wrong. Please don't critique me too much. I know a lot of the change-ups there were off time, but is this something weird about in my eyes anyhow? I'm sure I can tighten it up now. It was fun, and I'll probably do that. But I'm going to go back and listen to the original version, because I really don't have anything to go off of right now. But we're trying to keep it real, keep it cool, and keep it nice. So this is how we are spending our Wednesday, I guess it is today, Wednesday, in the studio. I got some mixes I have to do today. I do a lot of stuff on the side too that I don't put on my YouTube channel. This whole YouTube thing for me, for as far as this goes, is new, but kind of old at the same time. I used to have a channel years back when quality didn't need to be that good, boys and girls, and you were monetized instantly without having 1,000 subs, and I quickly acquired a lot of subs. But then I shut that channel down because life got in the way. I went through a divorce. I lost my whole recording studio, my drum building company. That's right. I had a company called Wicked Nation Custom Drums by Bakerpercussion. And I built a lot of top-notch, what I like to consider top-notch quality drum kits. And now here I am in this small little studio in this big Victorian home with something I never thought I'd ever say. A electric drum kit, a ROLAND vad306, that I find extremely fun to play on. And I might have to do a little expansion pack with another tom, or maybe experiment with some new modules. Although, because I want to add some more, if I'm going to be doing this kind of stuff, I definitely need to expand the kit, because Neil Peart has one of the most massive kits as far as really playing on out there, and quite beautiful kits too. Beautiful, beautiful drum kits he had by DW did his kits. They were beautiful works of art, and they sounded so good. I'm an acoustic drummer turned electric drummer, not because I want to, but because it helps with the neighbors. If I am picking up some feedback in the studio today, I do apologize. They are doing something outside once again, and it's causing some interference. So I do apologize, or maybe it's those big solar flares they're talking about. Or maybe they're just testing the power grid to see when it's going to collapse, because they're on a collapse. Who knows? We're going to a different subject. Different channel, different time, different discussion. Sure you give me, though. So, guys, what'd you think? Was it okay for not knowing it? Or should I just hang it up? Because I kind of feel like I should hang it up after that one. He's a tough act to follow for sure. But sometimes we just got to try. I appreciate each and every one of you. I appreciate everyone who stuck around, even through the channel transfer over to the drumming channel at Fulton Street Beats and drumming reviews. I really appreciate every one of you. God bless you all and have a fantastic day. Hello and welcome. Bye-bye, guys.